So. Ich wollte gerade sagen, der einzige Twitch-Streamer, der gerade Phoenix Wright streamt. Aber nein, es gibt noch einen anderen. Und der ist auch bei Teil 5. Sogar ein bisschen weiter.
February 23, 2:15 p.m. Wright & Co. Law Offices.
Mr. Wright, so. What's going on with the case anyway? I'm a little confused. Huh? Let's see. What is going on? The victim, Detective Bruce Goodman, was stabbed to the death after 5 p.m. on the 21st. He died in the prosecutor's parking lot and the police department's evidence room. What's this "and the evidence room" part? The prosecutor's office and the police department are 30 minutes apart by car. Well, that's what we're going to find out. Or try to, at least. Alright, let's do it. Glad she's in good spirits, but I'm not sure she's going to be much help with this.
Wow.
Fucking rude, Phoenix. Don't be so sure, Mr. Wright. Huh? Look, we're in this together, right? I proved that these thick-rimmed glasses of mine aren't just for show. Let's go, science awaits us. No, I really don't think we should worry about the police department murder. There wasn't even the body found there. Who cares? Ich glaube deine Schwester. Yeah, it was only our victim who was killed in the evidence room. No biggie. Besides, my sister would never do such a thing. I know it. That oil drum, was it empty? The oil drum kicked over by the chief prosecutor was brimming with water. My sister, erasing evidence at the crime scene? Never. Even though she says they don't get along, Emma really likes her sister. That's not it all. It's just... we're both professionals at what we do, and I trust her. Big words for a high school student. Well, whether there was blood on the floor or not. The water in that oil... oh... the water in that oil drum washed it all away. Ignore the strength of my science at your own peril, Mr. Wright. Huh? Such luminol. What's that grin for? The situation calls for one thing, and that is luminol testing fluid. Luminol? Blood is sticky stuff, you know. You can just wash it away with a little water. Even if you can't see it, it's still there. But wouldn't the police have already done those tests? Never trust anyone's eyes but your own, Mr. Wright. Sie haben auch nicht einen Muffler im Muffler gefunden. Just give it a try. Jetzt interessiert mich gerade. Wie haben sie das im Deutschen gemacht mit dem Muffler? Ich glaube Schal und Auspuffrohr. Haben sie dafür auch ein passendes Wort? Me? Why do I have to do it? I'm a minor. I can't even drink yet. We're testing bloodstains with this stuff, not drinking it. Here, look. I'll lend you these glasses. Huh? You had an extra pair of those things? To test for a blood reaction, just spray the luminol on it. Like this, see? Oh, press enter to spray it on. Okay, let's find us some bloodstains. Huh. Hier oben bestimmt. Oder hier. Ich muss noch draufklicken. Wow. I can see her eyes shining behind those glasses. So, is this a bloodstain?
It's so. Ah. Oh, was, magst du kein Blut? Emma, you're sh Oh no, you're shaking. It's just. This is my first time seeing real blood. Scientific investigation in action. Okay, well, we definitely know that this is a blood stain. Doesn't something strike you as odd? Scientifically speaking, of course. What's odd about this scientifically? Location. Why, the bloodstain's location, of course. It's elementary. Huh? Why is that elementary? I mean, I would think that if there was a fight, you'd expect some bloodstains here. I suppose you might think that. Come on, Mr. Wright. We're all counting on you. There's something odd about this bloodstain. If it's not the location of blood, then maybe. Maybe it's the amount of blood that's odd. I definitely think so. I mean, look at all the blood on the sole of the victim's shoe. It is pretty strange. If they fought here, that have to have been more blood than this. Hey, Mr. Wright. I'm gonna mark up the floor plans when we find the blood stain, okay? See, I'm pretty handy to have around, right? Yeah, and this stuff's pretty handy too. I saved up my allowance to buy that. Luminol testing fluid received from one very proud-looking Emma's guy. Solution used for scientific investigation. Finds blood traces. Spray to use. We can't be sure that the police will reveal all the evidence in court. Sometimes they fail to mention evidence that doesn't fit with their view of the case. Then let's drag that hidden evidence out into the light of day. Yeah. Fleek was really investigating a crime now, doesn't he? Doesn't it? Guess I should give this a spray on anything suspicious. Psst, psst, psst. Huh. I wonder how that fluid of yours would react to a nice deli box. Der neue und aufstrebende Twitch-Streamer kann Name Date One. Ist das noch ein Trademark daneben? Alle, sorry. I wonder how to react to a nice deli box. Mister? You only trust your own eyes, Not bad, you two. The stay-old deli box is on the house. Sorry, it's just that kind of lead-in doesn't really get my mouth watering. Oh nein, Herr Luwu. Wir haben ihn verloren. Exakt. Können wir dich auch mit Luminol einsprühen? Ah, oh, sie ist weg. Aha! This blood must be from Wen Lana. No, my sister isn't a murderer. Oh nein, wann hat meine Maisbewegung gesehen? Shit. But she did call you, didn't she? At the time of the crime? The right hand is bandaged. Hey! Whose side are you on? This has nothing to do with taking sides. So, this means that Lana's hand had blood on it. This just keeps getting worse. So, mehr sollte es ja eigentlich nicht geben. Is through there. That's where visitors park. So, Mr. climbed over this fence? It seems so, yeah? That fence is 9 feet high, at least. Well, no time like the present. I think I'll give it a little try.
Eek!
It's okay, don't cry. Maybe there's a Lunchland Olympics team. Sie können ja auch irgendwie hier mit dem Dings drüber gekommen sein, oder? Mit dem Truck. A-Block, this area is reserved for prosecutors. Defense attorneys are relegated to B-Block. I dream of the day when I'll be able to park my car here. Das hatten wir ja schon. I go over to B-Block to buy my hamburgers from you, Mr. Wright. I'm planning on giving up my job that soon. That's about as red as a sports car can get. Yep, it's pretty red, alright. Armer Edgeworth. Er hat jetzt kein Auto. Wer fährt ihn rum? Bestimmt Gumshoe. The lock on the trunk was broken too. The question is, why did Miss Sky choose his car? So, what model car is it? I think it was called a sedan or a coupe. Something like that. Those are car types, Mr. Wright, not models. You're a guy, aren't you, Mr. Wright? You're supposed to know these things. Maybe it's about time I get my driver's license. Stimmt, war das nicht so... Stimmt, ich glaube, im Anime fährt da jemand ein Fahrrad rum. This rope, is it? Yep. They laid in the outline of the victim's body. So wait. The victim must have died when the killer closed the trunk on him. You have got to be the only person I know that would come to that conclusion. Hey, got him. So, this is the famous oil drum. Well, no time like the present. I try to kick it over myself. Hiya! That's okay, don't cry. That Lana's guy must be one strong woman. Ada. That's where we found the note. That note. 221SL9. There's a 9 incident. A case that was due for transfer the day of the murder. The detective in charge of the case was the victim. I wonder what kind of case this SL9 incident thing was. It's kind of hard to guess just knowing the case number. Schild 1, Schild 3. Es fehlt noch ein Schild 2. So, dann scheinen wir hier alles mal zu haben. The partition. So, this is the famous divider. He will not divide us. Joe helped us knock a hole in the testimony today. Come to think of it, this divider helped our case more than the actual witness. The great divider, chip of the old parking block. It's just a wall, scientifically speaking. So that's where Miss Star saw the incident from. Can probably see quite a lot from up there. That probably means she wasn't lying when she said she saw Miss Sky stab him. Ja, den Engel kann ich sie dann eigentlich von da oben nicht sehen. Sie kann ja nur die Rückseite sehen. Da ist auch der Muffler schon weg. Where's the security guard anyway? Well, this is just something I heard. Apparently he went out to buy coffee from a star. That woman's a force to be reckoned with. Look, a door. This must mean something. Should doors mean anything? No, it won't open. A mysterious lock. I fail to see what's mysterious about it. Mr. Wright, you need to learn to enjoy life more. Let's finish our investigation first, shall we?
Aha, a ladder. That's a step ladder. What's the difference? In scientific terms, please. Scientific, huh? Look at the basic nature of the thing, Mr. Wright. This all seems so horrible familiar somehow. Ah, some sort of intelligence. Here, a phone. Let's see if it works. Hey, don't touch stuff you don't need to be touching. I can't hear anything. My ears. No, my ears. Maybe it's due to the barometric pressure. What is she babbling about? Hey, what did you just say? See, you can hear just fine. The phone's broken. Now we have another league champion. This is where the cars leave the lot. They're on the ground, makes it look more like an entrance. What are you talking about? It's plainly an exit. Well, maybe it's both. Kind of a dual purpose. Aha! The theory of relativity. What? I've got to write this down. Ah, hey, Mr. Wright. Maybe you know. German or British? Mr. Relativity? Are you sure that was his name? Certainly put me in a tight spot today. Today? Naja, wir haben um 12 Uhr aufgehört, also naja, können wir auch ein bisschen investigieren, denke ich mal, für den Tag. My apologies, Mr. But. No, it's okay. It was my fault. Oh, we know. I witnessed everything from the security room right there. I was afraid that wouldn't sound convincing enough, you see. I was wrong to think that. I'm sorry. Sorry? You lied on the witness stand. That's unforgivable. Little girl, don't forget what's important here. Even if the place I witnessed the events from was different, I still saw what I saw. I saw Chief Prosecutor Sky stab a man in cold blood, and that testimony still stands. I swear it on my honor as a detective. She stabbed Goodman. I'm sure Wolf has something important to tell us, but what? So you were detectives, weren't you, Mr.? Yes. It was a long time ago. Well, 2 years ago. No matter how hardened the criminal when they faced me. They coughed it up. Coughed it up? They confessed. They babbled like babies. You know. I may seem like a demon sometimes, but I can be an angel too. Spiel. I wouldn't doubt it. Every day I dragged the dirt out of the mouths of suspect after suspect. And before long they called me the cough up queen. Oh, and here I thought someone had gotten food poisoning from your lunches. And you were let go? Fire? I had found my dream job when I became an investigator. If this prime and proper prosecutor hadn't let me go, I'd still be one today. It's all because of that case. The SL9 incident. SL9? Wait, she doesn't mean... Warte, wir können sie nicht danach... What? Müssen wir wirklich präsenten? Oops, falscher Knopf. That looks like a petrified piece of provolone. Huh? It's not. It's my attorney's badge. I think a petrified piece of provolone would fetch more on the open market. Look, my badge isn't up for sale. Not yet, at least. schnell spielen. Had one of those up until 2 years ago. Back when you were a cover-up queen, right? Found this ID card here in this parking lot. Well, there's no mistaking that. It's definitely Goodsman's. But it's the same ID as the man who was killed at the police department. That's impossible. Wish I could be so sure. Jetzt kannst du das mit Enter machen. Could you take a look at this? You. Yes? You said you wanted some hot tea, right? No, but thanks. You didn't even look at it. You must have to brew the leaves a long time to get rich flavor like this. Wieder Chat Tea Leaves Enjoyer. Steam wieder uns alles. Body with Edward's knife stuck in it was found in Edward's car. I think you owes me his gratitude. Gratitude? Why, if I hadn't witnessed a crime, Mr. Edward would have been the suspect. I wonder. Still, it's strange. Why didn't our chief prosecutor have her own murder weapon ready? Take a look at this. Okay, we got nix. So natürlich auch nix. Lass mal versuchen. Ich habe gesehen, dass es ein Achievement gibt, wenn sie alle ihre Lunchboxes uns zeigt. Ich glaube, das muss man ein bisschen so triggern. What do you think about this? It's a 9 incident. It's written on that knife. And on that note. Good man. Goodman was the head detective on that case, you know? Really? That knife was evidence from that case. The murder weapon. It was due for transfer the very day that Goodman was killed. As I suspected. SL9 isn't over. Not yet. Do you think you could tell us more about the SL9 incident? It was when I grabbed the chief prosecutor on the shoulder. She dropped that knife on... She dropped that phone on the pavement. That's when you heard her talking about the muffler, right? Little did I know, it was a trap. The red car's muffler and the prosecutor's red muffler. What was Miss Guy really trying to say, I wonder? Ach, wieder nix. If you think about it, I could have taken that picture from the guard room. But even I got flustered sometimes. So you went straight to the scene of the crime? I rushed towards the chain link fence in an effort to stop the murder. That's when I took this picture, yes? In other words, 5 minutes after the crime? Those 5 minutes, 5 minutes are the whole problem. The hole in my testimony, as it were. The 5 minutes weren't the problem, mister. The lying was the problem. Listen, little girl, I've had my testimony disregarded before. And I wasn't going to have it disregarded again. Just like that time. That time? Could you take a look at this? This ugly mix. What do you think about this? Just on the knife, on that note. Sagst du denn zu Luminol? Ne, leider nix. So, SL9 incident. That incident really opened up my eyes to the truth. We're nothing to them. Disposable. Disposable? To who? 2 years ago, it was the biggest case I've ever handled. Die sehen aus wie ein Fasching. The police and the prosecutors were desperate for decisive evidence. So, they didn't solve it? On the contrary, it was solved quite cleanly. The criminal was caught and executed. Executed? Yes, the criminal got what was coming for to him. It doesn't get any cleaner than that. The only problem was, they never did find decisive evidence. Not a shred. What? But the criminal was executed, right? On the basis of evidence, of a sort, made-up evidence. What? You mean they executed someone with fabricated evidence? The best part came several months after the trial. Every detective involved with the case was dealt with. Some were demoted to patrolmen, others found themselves out of a job. And you were one of those? Myself and one other person you know well. Wait, could it be? Exactly, Detective Jake Marshall. Oops, I mean Police Department Security Detail Officer Jake Marshall. As professional detectives, we investigated that case from every angle. Jake was particularly determined. And then it was over, and he was demoted. However, he hasn't forgotten, and neither have I. You haven't forgotten SL9? There was another side to that case, a hidden side. That's what we're after now. And no one up in their fancy offices can stop us. Wait! Those lunches you sell? There's only one reason I come to sell lunches in this accursed office. I come here to meet old friends. Boyfriends that can help me investigate. Mistah's old boyfriends. How many does she have anyway? Just when all the detectives of SL9 have disappeared, we find new evidence. There has to be a connection. So, rookie. What? It seems like you're serious about investigating this case. Yes. Then you should take this. Salisbury steak lunch? I know a certain guy who might help you if you tempt him with this. See from a star, excellent for putting Officer Marsh. Oh, spoiler! Mr. Officer Marshall, is he your, are you his, are you going out? Why do you want to know? I was just wondering what happened to him. A long time ago, when he was helping my sister to do cases, he was so nice. I got along so well with my sister, it made me jealous. And he was nice to me too back then. This would do when Officer Marshall was a detective. But now, he's so cold. Jake and I are merely cooperating on this investigation. Putting the past to rest, as it were. Nothing more than that. I see. Thank you. Officer Jake Marshall.
You'll give that to Jake like I asked, won't you?
You and... As you... Are you going out?
Uh-huh. So, dann geht's mal weiter. Hier gibt's... Ah. Well, where should we begin? Isn't it obvious we should begin with that, you know, that thing? The mystery of the victim, I guess. How could one man, Detective Goodman, be killed in two places simultaneously? Well, you see. Should go to the police department. The evidence room, was it? Not being very useful here, am I? No, no, you're being very helpful.
Oh, Mr. Edgeworth.
I know you're going through a tough time, Worthy. What's with all those rumors? You have even the defendant's chair just this past December. There was that business with him not reading that officer's report. Ah, about the killing in the police department, right. The chief of police was right about that. But I can't help but think. Someone at the police department doesn't like Edgeworth. So, können wir noch irgendwas Interessantes präsentieren? So, this is my attorney's badge. Ah, well, I've never seen a real one before. The first one who's actually been interested in mine, believe me. I give you $50 for it. Können wir jetzt eigentlich checken? Wow, my mouth is watering. I can almost hear the sound of steak frying on the grill. No doubt it's all cold and tough by now. Er mag's bestimmt so. No, I'm sure it's delicious. Mr. Porter hard into making this. So long as you didn't put any other organs in there. Bitte was? Let's see. Ingredients, meat. She must mean beef. She probably just wrote it generically. Yeah. Let's hope so. Of course, as a scientist, I have to check what additives you used. Go to town, huh? It stays here. Hours of sweat and labor. So that's why the sauce is so salty. Bruh. Wow, man kann es echt checken. Ah. Someone used a marker to write their name on this. Emma's guy. Don't tell me you bring this with you everywhere you go. Well, you never know where something might go down. Just what kind of a world do you think we live in? Murder mystery. Hello? So. What has had been in the car's exhaust pipe? It's evidence from an old case, right? Right, the CL9 incident. It was already solved, apparently. This knife was stolen on the day of the evidence transferal. Maybe I should look into this SL9 incident. This stuff is pretty expensive. You don't say. How much does it cost? I'd say about $10 per gram. I save for my allowance to buy it. Your allowance? Does your sister give it to you, Dad? Yes. We don't have parents. Right. Sometimes she even gives me a bottle instead of... Oh. Ich dachte erst an eine andere Flasche. Sometimes she even gives me a bottle instead of my allowance. A bottle of luminal testing fluid? Man, I just take the allowance myself. Yes, it is. Ah, I've noticed that defense attorneys have a tendency to want to show people things. What is this? Imperial Institute of Lawyers? This photograph. Mistah must have been seeing things. And photographing things? This proves Mistah was there at the scene of the crime. She's connected to this crime somehow. But how? Here, see this? Ah, I've noticed. Okay. Sie ist eigentlich. Ja. Da und da Blut. Pardon for Miss Star's testimony. Miss Guy used her phone right after my murder. She called you, right? Hat es jetzt geschafft, in der Tiefgarage ein Telefonat zu erreichen? Muss man auch erstmal schaffen. But she hung up right away. It was a bad connection. I couldn't hear anything. Because it was an underground parking lot, I suppose. She did say something about the muffler. But got cut off. Can you see this? So, Mr. Edgeworth's knife was the murder weapon. Right. So the witness, Miss Stark, claims. She saw your sister stab Mr. Goodman with this knife. No, all of this is that Angel Star's fault. She's not the one on trial here. Well, no, but she must have seen it wrong. Her eyesight isn't on trial here either. Bet you're pretty heavy with a King of Attorney's shield too, huh? His defense attorneys are a scattered, unrecognized bunch. Still, I wonder why the trophy still is broken. It is pretty odd, huh? I doubt it has anything to do with this case, though. So, aber... Muss ich da noch irgendwas nochmal checken? Hey, check it out. There's a metal plate here. It looks like the name of all the previous recipients are engraved on it. Wow, one guy's listed a bunch of times. Von Karma. I guess he must be a foreigner. Yeah, that's probably it. Well, wherever he's from, he must have been an amazing prosecutor. I'd like to meet this Miss Karma von sometimes. And she says that his name does have kind of a ring to it. Yeah, ich glaube, das jetzt nicht just alles checken nochmal. Lass ihn talken, ne. Then move it. Looks like Miss Guy isn't questioning. The detectives aren't yelling at her. How did you kill her in two places at the same time? Can you imagine? How's she supposed to answer that? Wait a second. Didn't Mr. Gant say that arrested a suspect in a police department murder? Let's come back later. Smile for the camera. Any smilers in the chat? This guard monitors the visitor's room. One murder at the prosecutor's office, one at the police department. He must be frozen with fear, thinking that he might be next. Don't scare the poor guy. Everyone looks deadly serious here. Well, there was a vicious murder of a detective down at the police department. Yes, but the same detective was also killed at the same time in the prosecutor's lot. It makes my head hurt. Well, first things first. Let's go check out the police department crime scene. Yes, you sound dead set on investigating. But don't mess up, or we could wind up dead. I doubt anyone wants more mysteries or dead bodies around here right now. But it doesn't look like anyone's going to help us much either. That must be one of the detectives. He's mumbling something to himself. I know, the killer used dry eyes. Ist das eine tiefe Conan-Referenz? Würde mir ein Ne, wobei, es war nicht Dry Eyes. Es war nur Eyes. Verdammt. If you put it between the ledge and the door, the room could be sealed shut. This is good. I will write this award for sure. He's not writing a report. He's writing a novel. These are the detective's desks. There are computers and files on each one. Funny, they're a lot tidier than I expected. Guess the detectives don't spend a lot of time at the desk. Warum ist hier so still? This must be the chief of detectives. He's glued to his computer screen. What? Detective killed in the evidence room? Tell no one outside the police department? No. I told that old lady at the restaurant everything. Someone's getting a demotion. Oh, wie süß. So this is the police mascot, is it? The blue badger, the future star of the police force. The sign's a little changed from the one outside. Oh, well, the dancing blue badger, trademark reserved, is still under development, you see. Oh, it's like the chief. You have it trademarked? Absolutely, it's cutting edge stuff. Very now. I showed this doll here to my daughter and she burst into tears. I showed a moving mock up outside then. You gave her nightmares. A poster of a female police officer. Wait, no, that's the latest. Oh no! Wait, no, that's the latest Babes in Uniform calendar. My bad. That's pretty hard. Even busier here today than it was yesterday. The detectives are running around so fast they're blurring. I suppose this makes sense. A detective did get killed here after all. So, the evidence room. The scene of the crime. According to the pamphlet we got at the front desk. Here it is. Like a kid at an amusement park. Oh, a real crime scene. Let's go take a look. Wir hatten doch schon eine. The blue badger is still revving around today. Give him the benefit of the doubt and say he's dancing. Speaking of dancing, the whole police department has been dancing around like crazy since yesterday. Can I take out these batteries? I just can't help but feel he's going to do something naughty. The usual wanted posters are hanging up on the bulletin board here. Do you know this face? If you do, dial 911. Ich habe immer. Letztes Mal habe ich mich gefragt, was sie in Japan anrufen. You know, Mr. Wright, I always thought it was kind of funny. I've never seen anyone who looked like the people in these posters. Ja, man will sie auch, glaube ich, nie sehen. They hardly even look human. She has a point. Look, that patrolman is saluting that other guy. He must be a detective. You idiot, what were you thinking? Where's your head? Sir, it's right here, sir. I guess he wasn't saluting. He was showing the detective where his head was. They make a good pair. Mr. Wright, do you know... Das hatten wir schon. Do you know why patrol cars are painted black and white? No idea why. Well, I think they're designed after a panda. A panda? Not that I have a scientific proof. It's just a theory. Do you mind me asking how you came up with that theory? It was when I was on a school trip. I saw a patrol car and it came to me. We'd just been at the zoo, see? What about zebras? Or did they not have those at your zoo? The tigers in there look pretty busy. Just imagine, right now. Behind those doors, a police drama in action. Somehow the thought fails to excite me. I always get excited when I come to a police station. Why is that? Just feels like I've jumped into a movie. Huh? You know, with all the police and criminals. Well, I don't know if this is all that exciting. Sure it is. Look at those two officers over there. They're probably talking about the latest bust. Funny, I thought they were talking about the weather. Oh. Oh boy. Er hat sogar eine Falle ausgelegt. Ach, Jake. What's with the decor in this place? It's very eccentric. According to the pamphlet, this is a guard station for the evidence room. So, beyond the door is the evidence room, the scene of the crime. Sure seems that way. Oh. What's wrong? It's those cacti. They're so prickly. So imposing. It's hard to think straight. Ich weiß gar nicht. Ich muss gerade an diesen ASD. Nee, ASDF-Shot denken. Mit den. Son, don't touch that cactus. You're dead to me. If you can't handle the cacti, stay out of the desert. What I want to know is, if this is a guard station, where's the guard? I have a feeling I know who he is already. Look, on the floor, a lasso. Looks like it's set up to trap something. A trap here? Wait, I know. Maybe someone was trying to catch a wild bull in here, but a lasso missed. Soll eigentlich wirklich keine Musik sein gerade im Moment? You sure have an active imagination. The swinging doors make the place look like some kind of saloon. But look, it's nailed shut. We can't get in that way. Of course not. If we went in through here, the cactus will fall over. Ouch! I'd say it would me of Jörg myself. Yipes, these straw are prickly. They must be the real deal. I would think just one big one would be sufficient. These cacti, a lot like my sister, actually. Ah, endlich Musik. How so? Encased in a cold, rigid shell, spines pointing in every direction. Just like her. I'm not sure I see the resemblance. It's more an attitude thing than a physical similarity. There's a security guard uniform hanging here. It looks more like a costume than a uniform, honestly. A leather jacket, leather pants, a leather. What was that call again? A punchy? A paunchy? A pinchy? I know, a poochie! War das nicht dieser Cartoon-Hund? Wait. Maybe that wasn't it. It's a poncho, but I think I'll keep that information to myself for the time being. Wow, rude. Look, there's a video feed from the evidence room here. There's a light blinking below the monitor. It says recording. I bet we could use this computer to check on who went in and out of here. Der harte Alkohol ist ja auch interessant. So, ich glaube, das ist mit den. Jetzt gehen wir zur Tür. The evidence room is beyond that door. Let's just walk in. Let's just jump right into it. It won't open. You thought it'd be open? I think we need someone's permission to go in there first. Und wieder raus. This place is charged with frantic energy, as always. Please. Huh? Wasn't that? Steak lunch, please. Oh, it's you. Detective Gumshoe. Now's not the time for chit-chat, Paul. Pal. I'm a busy man. What I really need is a steak lunch from Lunchland. You mean one of these? Actually, it's not for sale. Aww. I think I just heard the sound of his heart breaking. What have we done? What have we done? Now's not the time for despair. Hope! Despair! Hope! We've caught our criminal, now we just need the evidence. The criminal? You mean? How about us stabbing the police department evidence room, right, pal? On the same day that the detective was killed in the prosecutor's parking lot. Another detective was killed at the police department? And the perpetrator? Do you have a suspect? Well, there was a suspect. Just arrested them, in fact. It's the biggest scandal to hit the station in ages. Everything's topsy-turvy. But Detective Gumshoe, who was it? Listen, pal. All I know is I need my steak lunch pronto. Standing around here talking isn't going to fill my belly. Wait, don't leave. If you want to know more, head on down to the detention center, pal. Questioning should be over, so I figure he's down there having a good cry. Later. He ran off to the evidence room. Well, this investigation is off to a running start. Still, I do feel better about things. A little. I mean, they caught the person who stabbed Detective Goodman, didn't they? Yeah. I guess they did. Best not to go too far down that road right now. Things will just get confusing. Ich glaube, es war dieser Meekins, oder? Yeah. What was that? Sir, that's what I'm saying. Me? A perpetrator? I'd say I was the perpetrator against her. That's what I say. Aww. Hi. Greetings, sir. Wait, I know who you are. Excuse me, but is Mr. Edward, anywhere on the premises? I'm here, sir. At the request of the chief, sir. I've got your report, sir. Officer Meekins. So you're guard here at the detention center? No, sir. I'm not, sir. I'm a little lost patrolman, like a little lost lamb, sir. Oh, I get it. You're here to deliver a report? No, sir. How should I say this? Wait, he isn't. Is he? You... Officer Meekins. You didn't. Did you? Perpetrator Officer Meekins reporting, sir. Was ist dieses Gesicht? What? What? That isn't an unexpected turn of events. Look for the camera. Officer Meekins. think he knows he's being watched. Scout monitors the visitor's room. Seeing a fellow patrolman in here must make him worry about his own fate in life. Now comment from the peanut gallery. Won't be again. Sir, I'm a patrolman of General Affairs, sir.
Sir!
Ow. I can hear you fine, Officer Meekins. I had some business that day, sir, and so I went to the evidence room, sir. The guard station in front of the room was empty, sir. So normally there's a guard at the evidence room? That's right, sir, because evidence is kept in the evidence room, sir. No, the security officer was none other than Officer Marshall.
Marshall?
Then, sir, I happened to glance at the security room monitor. That's when I saw him, sir. A suspicious person in the evidence room. A suspicious person, sir. What the fuck? What the heck is this guy doing? So what happened then? After that, sir, everything went white. I saw red. I blacked out. And when I came to, I was here, the detention center. How long were you out? Days? Mother asks, what happened to your hand? Sir, there was no one to bandage me, sir. So I did what I could to wrap it up, sir. Bandage on his hand, just like Miss Sky. Yet another similarity between this case and the one at the police accuser's office. First things first, tell us how did you hurt your hand? I don't mean to pry, but you are the perpetrator, correct? You killed Detective Bruce Goodman in the evidence room, right? Sir? Please don't look at me with those sad puppy dog eyes, sir. If you have to label me as perpetrator or victim, sir, then label me as victim. Ich mag einfach, wie seine Hand einfach den Hammer-Sound macht. I would, but you happen to be in detention. And alive and well at that. And yes, well, that's true, sir. I suppose you could say that. Did you know the victim, Detective Goodman? Well, sir, if I had to label him as a stranger, or a total stranger, then I'd say he leans heavily on the total stranger side. So, you didn't know him? Sir, I work in a tiny department, devoid of light or other creatures' comforts. What the fuck? I don't know any detectives. So, if he was a total stranger, why did you stab him? I had no intention of killing him, sir. None. Nor do I have any recollection of killing him, sir. At least someone around here is more confused than I am. About your hand. Did it happen during the course of the crime? Well, you see, sir. Don't you think you shouldn't just confess? Don't you think you should just confess? But there was nothing I could do. Nothing you could do? Sir, to tell the truth, sir, when it happened, when the detective pointed that knife at me, I just hollered, sir. The next thing I knew, I was unconscious. The next thing you knew, Then, when I opened my eyes, I was alone in the evidence room, sir, all alone. Alone because Detective Goodman had disappeared. What? Then when I looked down, I was gushing blood from my hand, sir. Oh, the shock. Oh, the sorrow, sir. Can you imagine how I felt? The victim's body? Disappeared? That's some story. Professor Meekins, have a look at this. Go ahead, sir, laugh. Laugh at me, sir. I know what you want to say. You're going to tell me how she has one just like it. Me? Why would I? I know, sir, I know. I'm the only one without a girl with magic badges. Nowhere. I'm alone. All alone. Is that so wrong? Life isn't all about high school sweethearts and youthful romance, sir. Is he talking about those badges on her coat? I'd like to think there's a difference between my badge and a fashion accessory. Do you think you could take a look at this? Hey! That's it, sir. That's it. That's it. That's what? My head was a blank until this very moment. But sir, now I remember. I remember, sir. You mean you remember what happened? Correct. That card. That card was the cause of it all. This idea card? Exactly, sir. That's exactly it. Nothing could be more exact, sir. Nothing. Better pry into this one a little deeper. Officer Meekins, could you take a look at this? So, sir, I'm really sorry, but I have no idea what this is. Maybe you should ask Mr. Edgeworth, sir. He's passing the buck, Mr. Wright. It takes a special kind of man to pass the buck to Edgeworth. Oops. Okay, this is always nice. Officer Meekins, this is for you. I'm scared of knives, sir. Oops. That's it, sir. Last night, sir. That's the one. I was an apple, sir. In my dream, sir. And I was being peeled. On second thought, you don't have to look at a knife. He's overreacting to the knife. But I guess he's been through a lot. Hey, why do you have that? That's from the day. It was taken at the prosecutor's office. Today that Detective Goodman's body was found in the trunk. So this means... This means I'm a free man. Innocent. This is a dream, sir. Then I hope I never wake up. If this is a dream, you'd better wake up right now. Macht es beide bei beiden Messern. So, da können wir jetzt nochmal über das Neue talken. Can you tell me what it is you do remember? Well, sir, you might say that I'm a lost little patrolman, a lost little lamp, if you will. Man sieht nirgends sein Gesicht. I didn't know Mr. Good Detective Goodman, who was in the... Oh, jemand hat sich einfach mit seiner ID-Karte eingeschlichen. That's why you thought he looked suspicious. Sir, I entered the evidence room and asked the man to show me his ID card. Well, that sounds pretty much by the book so far. That's right, sir. That's what I've been trying to tell you. So you asked Detective Goodman to show his ID card. What did he do? That's the thing. Suddenly he pointed a knife at me. What? Sir, I assure you I was flustered as you are right now. So I whopped and leapt at him. Detective Goodman pointed a knife at him? Do unto to others before they do unto to you. My own father's words, sir. What happened then? Well... My eyes, sir. Everything went white. When I awoke, I was here. Right. Das macht doch aber timeline-mäßig auch keinen Sinn. Er wird im Evidence Room umgebracht, der Report wird gemacht und er liefert ihn ab. Und jetzt ist er im Knast. Hä? So, Officer Meekins, why was it that they arrested you? What do you mean, Emma? Let's look at what we know. No, Officer Meekins didn't know Detective Goodman. And the victim whom he met at the scene of the crime didn't show his ID card. In other words, we have no way of knowing if the victim was really the victim. And if this body just disappeared from the evidence room, we don't even know if anyone actually died. That's it, sir. That is what I wanted to say. That is, I did say something along those lines. Huh? But you still ended up here. They told me that it had to be him, sir. And that day, at that time, Detective Goodman was definitely in the evidence room. That's what they said. But you don't remember the events clearly? No. But the videotape is quite clear. Huh? Videotape? From the security camera. The crime, my crime. The crime I swore to stamp out. It's there. It's me. It's on tape. You waited until now to tell us this? Sorry, really sorry. I'll hand over a badge. I don't deserve it. No thanks. I have my own. Well, guess we better go check out the crime scene. Hey, Mr. Wright. Look who's standing at the Chief of Detectives' desk. It's Police Chief Gant. You sure this is all, huh? You know what it means if there's anything missing? Sir, I'm sure it's most likely totally perfect. Oh, shit. Under his seat cushion, behind his computer monitor, inside his personal coffee machine. I see. Well, if anything does turn up, you call me right away, deal? Yes, sir. We scout the place again, sir. The Chief of Detectives looks a bit little flustered. Righto, my boy. How you been? Swim much? Oh, Chief Gant. Reporting for duty, sir. Why are you saluting him, Mr. Wright? And no, the killer used a cassette tape. What a crafty trick. That gunshot was a fake. This is good. No one will expect a cassette tape in this day and age. I'm writing a report, a novel. Oh, sorry you had to see that. What exactly did the chief of police want you to do? Well, see over there? That's Goodman's desk. He wanted me to check it for anything that might be a clue. Took away every last piece of garbage in the trash can. So nothing belonging to Detective Goodman is still here? Of course not. Well, except for this. What? You kept something? Sure, why not? It's not important. He didn't even finish writing it. It's a lost item report, but it's only half complete. A lost item? Did Detective Goodman lose something? The date on it is this February 21, but I make a note of that just in case. half-written document dated February 21. Can only be submitted to the chief of police. Should really get back to investigating the police department crime scene. Seine ID verloren. War sich auch nicht sicher über die Nummer. Is Edward going to be okay? Oh, Ravi. Oh, you know, you're doing a little inquiry committee with him. Sounds like an inquisition. Yep, well, they've had no end of trouble with the boy since last year. You mean, the incident on God Lake? It doesn't look good having a top prosecutor sit in a defendant's seat, does it? And you, met someone else found guilty in that case, right, Ryder? Oh boy. Das Gesicht von Karma. A legend he was, undefeated in his 40-year career. Then in court you fixed it, so he was caught for forging evidence. Wait, I didn't do anything wrong. He did forge evidence. In any case, the prosecutor's office is in a bit of turmoil, you might say. Why, they just do about anything to restore their reputation. Now, depending on what was inquired on what that inquiry committee decides. It could be bad for Worby. What? It sounds rather odd, I tell you. The detective getting killed on that turf, too, I mean. There being the prosecutors, I assume. Scientifically speaking, it's impossible. Yes, but that's what the evidence is saying. Goodman was stabbed in two locations at the same time. That's what I say. What it says. What evidence is this? Now, Ryder, I can't give away all our secrets just like that. And this in particular, well, it's a little sensitive. I can't talk about it. Wasn't expecting much anyway. No, one thing I hate most of all is hiding stuff. Secrets. Can't stand them. But you know, it's a full-time job just keeping the chief of detectives trap shut. Ah, he was the one you were picking on earlier. Huh? You saw that? Whoops. I wonder what it was that he wanted the chief of detectives to do. Let's see if we can kind of discreetly ask him. Actually, I was wondering if you could ask you a favor. Well, I never thought the day would come when Ryder asked me for help. I was wondering if we could investigate the evidence room. Hell no, son. Now, Ryder. Actually, I'm sorry. I don't need to investigate at all, after all. Ryder, please. Do I look like a selfish man? Huh? Heck, if anyone asked me, sir, can I borrow $50? I'd give them $50, no problemo. So go ahead, investigate the room to your heart's content. Knock yourself out. It just goes to show, you never know until you ask. And so you're here, you can borrow this. Hey, this is a detective's card, ID card, isn't it? That's a special card for guests, so don't lose it. Yes, sir. It's an honor. You just run along and do your best now, later. Later, folks. Oh, wir konnten ihn nichts präsentieren. Haha, it looks pretty cool on my lapel. Lapel? Doesn't it? Just think, A real idea. You seem happy. Yes, sir, because, sir, we get to go into the evidence room now, sir. I think this place is a bad influence on the girl. Warte, kann ich ihn jetzt noch? Nee. Ah, okay. Hat so ein bisschen so in die Richtung genannt, so, ey, da ist noch was. Geh doch mal dahin. The evidence room is beyond that door. We have the ID card from Chief Gant. Let's just walk in. It won't open. Aha. The card really just turned off, see? What is that security guard thinking? Howdy, partners. Well, well, what's made my Bambino sky so gray? Officer Marshall? Why does it have to be him? What's that? Why does it have to be him look for? As you may have surmised, this here's my saloon. We're here to investigate a crime scene. Yeehaw! That card you got there is on your chest. It's better than a sheriff's badge in these parts. Yeehaw? Well, what you're standing there for? Get along, little doggies. The crime scenes are waiting. Looks like the card reader is on again. While we're here, I was wondering if we could ask you some questions. Sorry, cowboy, but I got no mind to tangle with your hombres. You're busy then? Did I say that? I only said I didn't wish to speak with you. Actually, you said you had no mind to tangle with us hombres. Ah, oh, wir haben genau das Richtige für dich. That smell, reminds me of Texas. So, Officer Marshall, you're from Texas? Hell no. No. I just saw a special on television the other day. Is this from my baby? Yeah, Miss Star. What's this? What's wrong? A Philly steak lunch. I see. I don't see. I wonder what it means. Steak lunch given to Officer Marshall. Alright, Bambino. Bambina. You win. Ask anything. Schmeck. Finally, it seems like he's willing to talk. Hallo, Trix. Da lurkt er einfach. Aw, das sind cute Emotes. Damn. Shows back in the Wild West didn't place much faith in evidence. But the only thing they trusted was their shooting hand. This is neither wild nor west here. Aha! But that and this are two different things entirely. I guess so, huh? I'm lost. Looks like we need some evidence to get anywhere with this guy. Geht er auf nichts gerade oder müssen wir noch irgendwas triggern? Ich glaube, wir müssen irgendwo noch was triggern. Ich habe einfach den Gen gemacht, mal noch in dem Channel, aber nehmen wir den Giftsat mit. Immer ist gut. Ja. Ich habe auch hier das irgendwann zwei Tage später, nachdem ich in den Kanal reingeguckt habe, bekommen. Examen. This cactus sure is prickly. It must be real. Best keep your distance from Billy there. You're liable to get hurt. Billy, the cactus has a name? Billy, you're wearing your cowboy hat on your hand. Ah, my rawhide cowskin 10-gallon hat. I just picked it up, but Billy took a fancy to it. Boah, der hat auch das gleiche Mode. Looks like it got stuck on the spines and you couldn't get it off. A leather jacket, a leather pants and a leather... Those aren't pants, those are chaps. And that's a poncho up there. Aha, a poncho. Sure looks cool, but the name is a little silly. You sure have a lot of monitors in here. There's 8 cameras in the evidence room in all. One for each section. Which monitor shows the section where the crime took place? Why do cattle sit before the rains come? It's not for a man to know. Unless you're the security guards responsible. Look at his swinging door. Just like a Wild West saloon. Sorry partner, but we're closed for the day. Huh? You'll get along home now? I think Officer Marshall really wanted to be a Wild West bartender. I always wanted to say that. So. Zeit für Fragen. Officer Marshall, you're in charge of security for the evidence room, right? You got good eyes, partner. It's an easy job, and I'm grateful for it. Actually, Officer Meekins at the detention center told us. Ah, that poor little doggy. Poor guy, I kept getting his name wrong and calling him Meekly. Wow. Arbeitsplatzbullying am Werk hier. He told us something. He said that when the stabbing occurred, you weren't at your station. Well, maybe I shouldn't be telling you this. Since I got demoted from detective 2 years ago. Well, it might not look it, but I lost my fire for the job, you know? So, what were you doing around 5:15 when the murder took place? Well, I reckon I was galloping down the highway on the back of my steed, Sippy. Note, he was riding down the highway on his horse named Sippy. There's no need for people here, anyhow. These newfangled machines do a bang-up job for keeping an eye on the place. You mean the security camera system? I don't take to machines much. They took our jobs. Kinda like the steward broccoli that sneak in next to your steak, you know? Mr. Star told us something. She said that you were a detective until 2 years ago. It was always my dream to be a rawhide wrangler on the scene of the crime. All gone now, like a drinking hole in a prairie of fire. You're still investigating the SL9 incident with Miss Star, aren't you? That was my case. It's all solved in the record books, but it smells like a bad game of poker. Can't let it go. That's all there is to it. What kinds of case was it anyway? I've heard the name so many times, but no one tells us what actually happened. There's some things you're better off not knowing, Bambina. Anyway, that case is officially dead as of 2 days ago. 2 days ago? The day of our case? That's right, the evidence transferals. Edward was talking about the transferals too. I know what maybe two of the machines in here do. Only two of them? There must be a dozen. Like I said, Bambina, me and machines, well... I like them about as much as I like stewed cauliflower with my steaks. The easiest one to understand are these here security cameras. Those are the ones that Officer Meekins mentioned. If nothing happens, the tapes are automatically erased every few hours. And Officer Meekins and Detective Goodman, are they on one of those tapes? I reckon they might be. You're a security guard and you reckon? One more thing. When you go into the evidence room, you need an ID card. That's the card reader by the door. The card reader leaves a record of every ID card that passes through. Oh, 420! Sieben mal die sieben. So this is the ID card record. Hey! I've seen that somewhere before. Sorry, Bambina. I can't show you more than that. Huh? I haven't heard whether this is related to the case yet. Mr. Wright. I saw a number on that record just now. I've seen that number before. Maybe there's some way I can prove that record is tied to the stabbing. Sorry, but could you explain what this whole transferal thing is about? We keep only evidence from solved cases in this room. They're kept there under the preceding detective supervision for 2 years. So we can reinvestigate them if it turns out there was a mistake, see? So what happens to the evidence after 2 years? Goes to sleep forever in the underground vault at the county sheriff's department. That's what we call transferal. We do it every February. See now? Transfer is like a funeral for old cases. Two years after a case is solved, it's closed forever. Dead. Never to be reopened again. Never to be reinvestigated. That happened to SL9 2 days ago. See this? This is a victim's ID card. Ah, the one that was on the ground in the parking lot? The number on this one is 58428189. Officer Marshall, show us that ID card record again. 5 years. Look, the fourth number. It's a perfect match. Was used at 5:40, right before the stabbing. What's more, there's only one of them cards in the world. So when the incident occurred, Detective Goodman was in the evidence room. So. But wait, what did Officer Meekin say? So I entered the evidence room and asked the man to display his ID card. So I asked Detective Goodman to show his ID card. What did he do? It's a thing. Suddenly he pointed a knife at me. If he had his ID card then... Why would he have pointed a knife at Officer Meekins? Alright, comparator, you win. Yes, I can give you this ID card report. I've got an idea. Maybe I should show this list to other people with IDs here. Wie fühlen sie aus, oder? Das muss ja dann Meekins gewesen sein. Das ist bestimmt Damon Gant. Und wer das ist, ist glaube ich noch die Frage. Ich habe einfach schon so viele Commands, ich habe nicht den Überblick über alle. So, endlich Zeit für den Big Crime Scene. Sektor R3. It's quiet. The investigation must be over here. So, this is the evidence room. It really is kind of like a graveyard. Graveyards are supposed to have grass and trees. This feels more like a morgue. Wie spricht man das aus? Morge? Keine Ahnung gerade. Nice try, Mr. Wright. You can't scare me. Oh, hello there. Whoa. Sorry, thought you were a ghost. Wouldn't recommend going around smacking ghosts on the head, pal. So is this true what I heard? Rather please, do I look like a selfish man? Heck, if anyone asks me, sir, can I borrow $50? I'd give them $50, no problem. So go ahead, investigate the room to your heart's desire. Knock yourself out. Wir wollten erstmal die Gemschuhe ausknocken. Yeah, it's true. The Chief of Police Gant will loan anyone 50 bucks? Even me? Oh, so that's what you were talking about. Actually, I was put in charge of an investigation for today. Just for today? Boss for a day. But guess what? You got permission from the Chief. I know your boss for a day. Gee, thanks. First of all, you want to have this. Evidence room floor plans added to the court record. Uh-huh. Hello, Firebird. Auch mal wieder wach. Wow, look at this big pile of junk in the corner. That looks like a car door. There's a pair of handcuffs attached to the frame. Maybe the guy they caught was some sort of escape artist and he got away. Hey, rude. Hey, that's one of those human profiles for range testing. He's been shot square in the forehead. Better him than us. That's the door we just came in through. Looks like you don't need an ID card to get out. I wonder what could happen if Officer Marshall cut the power while we were inside. Let's hope he remembers we're in here. This place is stuffed with evidence, stuffed with dreams. I'm not so sure about the dreams. It won't open. Did you really think it would? Hey pal, our security is high-tech around here. There's something sticking out of here. Oh, stimmt. Looks like a shirt. Guess it must be evidence for some case. Wonder if Detective Gunshoe puts this here. There you go, pal, making me out to be some kind of slob. I'm not responsible for the evidence here. That said, I bet the evidence locker was opened recently. How do you know? If you leave things hanging out like that, the evidence gets stereo ripped. The guard checks on that kind of stuff and notifies the detective responsible. How many times have I had him breathing down my neck about some silly evidence? Sounds like the detective gunshot leaves evidence hanging out a lot too. I bet he doesn't tuck in his shirt under the trench coat either. Wow. If you're going to talk behind someone's back, don't do it right in front of them, pal. Machst du heute nur Ace oder spielst du noch Fiesta? Also mein Plan wäre gewesen, den Investigation-Teil zu machen bis zum nächsten Gerichtstag. Also je nachdem, wie lange das dauert. So. Some sort of bulky equipment scattering dust here. What a sorry looking fishing pole that is. Ah, that's my personal pole. I never did get around for using it. Wait, I've seen that somewhere. Die Referenzen. I've seen that somewhere before. Red pal, that's that metal detector. The one that led to the solving of that case out on God Lake, remember? Oh, right. Oh, that feels like it was ages ago. And, I don't think I've seen this one before. Oh, Dad. There's a bug sweeper. I'm sure it will come in handy in solving some case sooner or later. That cheap... God damn it, this is bestimmt so ein richtig dickes Foreshadowing. That cheap looking box? You can't judge a person or a machine by the cover. You gotta look at their heart. Suddenly Kingdom Hearts character here. What is the saw and paint doing here? Since the dawn of time, true art has always been a war against oppression. Ach, was, this thing is safe useless. Oh god, this is a djinn. True art? I noticed that there's blue and yellow paint here. Perhaps we're witnessing the birthplace of the blue badger? Well, you might say this is my studio. Here? In the evidence room? What is this? Blood? It's a little worn, but there's definitely a handprint here. It looked like someone tried to wipe it off. Miss Wright. What if there are other bloodstains he left in the room? You should use her testing fluid to check it out. Well, someone... Oh, ich glaube, ich erinnere mich daran. Das war auch ein neues Minigame. Well, someone has broken something big to make this... Oder ist es... Warte, ist das das Schild? Nee, das ist nicht die Farbe, oder? Well, someone must have broken something big to make all these pieces. Detective Gumshoe, perhaps? There you go, pal. Making me out to be some kind of hooligan. It's apparently from their case. Their case? The SL9 incident, pal. See the sticker on one of the pieces there? Another piece. I wonder what shape these pieces were in before whatever it was broken. You want to try to put it back together? Huh, good luck, pal. That's no job for amateurs. Why, I spent a good 3 hours on that before I had to give up. That's why I always carry around a tube of glue. Well, this piece looks like the bottom. Let's try putting the rest in place. Oh boy. Ach du Scheiße. Thank you. was erwartest du jetzt von hier? Tolles Minigame. Das war halt echt so. Ich hab diesen Teil noch irgendwo als Let's Play geguckt. Kann mich auch daran erinnern, dass da jemand drum gestruggelt hat. Oder es blieb einfach in Erinnerung. Was? Nicht? We did it. Some of the pieces are missing. Yeah, I got that far too in 2 minutes myself. The problem is finishing it. Were some pieces stolen? Wer hat da gestruggelt? Alle. But they were missing to begin with. Still. Doesn't look like the most stable kind of jar. Kind of understand how it got broken. Jar pieced back together from fragments found at a crime scene. A piece is missing. If you put these pieces together, it makes a jar. There are two things that bother me. One, why are some of the pieces missing? Too. Doesn't seem a little unstable. I wonder it broke. I'll make sure to remember the next time I make a jar. Look, this one's open. And the red indicator light above the door is lit. The locker is coated with Detective Goodman's fingerprint. Detective Goodman's locker? Are you sure it's okay to leave it open like that? Ja, wird schwierig, es wieder aufzumachen. Wow, it'd be hard to get it open again if we closed it. It's empty. They must have taken the contents elsewhere. Someone left a glove here, but only one. Detective Gumshoe, maybe? There you go, pal. Making me out to be some kind of absent-minded detective. This evidence from DKs, you know? You mean SL9? It does have a tag on it. Ooh, and a rubber glove. So. So, das hätten wir alles examined. Zeit zu reden. So, Detective Gumshoe, your boss for the day? That's right, it's an honor. After all, the murder took place right here, in the police department. But if your boss...
Why are you all alone? Where are your underlings? They're using yesterday's findings to prepare for tomorrow's trial. In other words, you got kicked out of the investigation. Again. I'm adamant, though. I'm going to take control and put this case to rest. In my own evidence locker, pal. You have a locker in here too, Detective Gumshoe? Haha, of course. I'm a detective, after all. They gave me a locker that only I can open, pal. Only you can open? I'll always believe in Mr. Edgeworth, no matter what happens. So, Mr. Edgeworth is with the inquiry committee now, right? They're trying to figure out who's responsible for the mess up in court today. I see. I guess this is what you call fate. Mr. Edgeworth just can't get away from that case. That case? Yes, that case. The SL9 incident, of course. This was the beginning of the end for Mr. Edgeworth. Maybe we can get him to tell us more about the case. This place is more high-tech than you might think. Every locker is fixed so that only one detective can open it. Using the ID card? Well, that's the thing, pal. ID cards can be lost. Well, why, I'm on my third card since entering the force already. That sounds like a lot. Yeah, but even I can lose my own right hand. Right hand? Oh, you mean your fingerprint? Exactly, pal. The lock for each locker is coded with a fingerprint. Oh, and photo. So the only locker we can open is our own. Funny, they look like normal lockers. These are the latest models. There's a trick to the handles, see? The handles? On the other side of this handle is a sensor, and if the wrong person touches it... Bzzz! You get a shock. If that's what happened, my hand would be black and smoking every day. In any case, the locks aren't that obvious. There are even some people on the force that don't know about the fingerprints locks. Only a assigned detective can unlock it. Indicator lamp lights it up when it's open. Can we assign examine? But an assigner blutet. Doctor, here's my attorney badge. He showed it to me every time we meet, pal. We'd men showed a police badge. Enough said. Wish I had that badge. Even the ID card would be nice. Ja, einfach die Hand abschneiden. Easy. Das ist der Victim, Detective Goodman's ID card. These days, everything's cards and secret numbers. I can never relax. It's only because you always lose your card. I also get my secret number too. Scary, huh? My face should be ID enough. What's the world coming to? Detective Gumshoe, rebel against the system. Hey, that's it. That's the King of Prosecutor award that Mr. Edgeworth got the other day. Were you at the award ceremony, Detective Gumshoe? Of course, pal. I got an award for diligence myself. Ah, congratulations. I was wondering, why is the award a shield? And why is this broken? Oh, there's a reason. I'll tell you what it is later. Apparently, he's forgotten. Found in Mr. Edgeworth's car, stabbed with Mr. Edgeworth's knife, huh? What would drive Chief Prosecutor Sky to do such a thing? Wait, I didn't mean... I mean, sure, of course someone else really did it. Someone who must have... Someone who has mastered a grudge against Mr. Edgeworth. So, something to use the slicer. This is my crowning achievement. My masterpiece, you might say. But art is always misunderstood, pal. Art? You're standing proudly on the day of the award ceremony. But there were a lot of people coming and going after the ceremony. Bestimmt das hier abgemacht. So I took the blue badge away for a while. Really? Why? Oh, they said it was shameful or something like that. Shameful. I told night and day. Sympathize with Detective Gunshoe. But I can see why they moved it. Allow me to say one thing, speaking as a detective. If I see a piece of evidence I know nothing about, I say nothing. Nothing. That's fine. Bet it's fine, pal. Get off this note and that switchblade knife. But Edgeworth was the most surprised of anyone. Because of the SL9 connection. That was Mr. Edgeworth's first big case, you know, 2 years ago. That was the first time the world knew Edgeworth was a man to be feared. But why would evidence from that case turn up now? Guess it's not over, pal. Maybe there are some loose ends left on that case. That's a photo that Miss Star took. Anything you can tell us about it? Miss Star is quite the lady. Why, remember, it was in winter. I was 16. She was the only one who ever got me to talk about what happened. This? 16. That's how old I am now. I wonder what happened. I wonder if Detective Gunshoe wore a trench coat in high school too. Oh, he was that kid, oder wie? Goddammit, haben wir schon viele Beweise zusammen? Can't open the locker if your fingerprints doesn't match. If you can open it, they'll give you 50 cents? No, the police department lacks faith in its lock system. After all, Detective Goodman has stepped here after opening his locker. Okay, seine Hände sehen auch normal aus. Warte. Das fällt mir erst jetzt auf. Oh shit. Es ist das SL9-Messer. Oh Leute, uns ist noch keinem aufgefallen. What the fuck? But at the same time, he was found dead over at the prosecutor's office. So, dann zeigen wir auch mal noch das ID-Card-Record. Could you take a look at this? This is the ID card record of the people who came in here on the day of the stabbing. Ah, I heard the rumors. Oops. Hey, das war zu schnell. Wow. What is it? That second number? It's not your ID number, is it, Detective Gumshoe? Mr. Edgeworth? What? The second number on this list belongs to Mr. Edgeworth. What? Oh, what the f- why would Edgeworth have come to the evidence room? Now that was a bloody, violent case.
Violent. So it was a murder. Serial killing. Serial killing. Maybe you don't want to get involved in this after all. But the killer made a mistake. Mr. Edgeworth built his case around that to nab him. This was 2 years ago. They put Mr. Edgeworth right in the spotlight and started a rumor mill. Rumors about forged evidence. It was supposed to be all cleaned up with the transfer the other day. It was the last job he ever did. Detective Goodman, that is. Huh? What do you mean? Detective Goodman was the detective in charge of the SL9 incident, see? So, it's switchblade knife. The victim took the knife out of the evidence locker room himself. Und mit dieser Antwort gehen wir einfach weiter. Also, weil jetzt suchen wir das Blut mit dem Luminol. Ich muss jetzt mal. Ich muss jetzt mal muten. Nein. Das dann hier, das Spray. Hätte das erwartet? I'm getting an erection here. There's no reason for the murderer to touch the spot if you fled out of the door. This just might be something significant. Hey, some pretty amazing stuff you got there, pal. What this? It's called luminal testing fluid. Where do you get your hands on that? The internet? Huh? I'd like to get some too. I just borrowed 50 bucks from the chief. Where do you get this, Emma? All this by mail order. Well, I better jot this down on the floor plans. Ach ja. I knew it. This is someone's right handprint. What? What's the matter, detective? This locker. It's mine. It's yours? Please, you have to help me. When they come to take me away, promise you'll testify that I wouldn't harm a fly. You'll do that for me, won't you, pals? This is an important clue. I jot it down on the floor plans. Counting on you guys. Believe me, you can't trust the police. What? But you're a detective. Oh. Okay, ich kann die. Ich darf nicht auf die Farbe. Was ist denn one massive pool of blood? Never seen anything like that. Not professional. What's your opinion, detective? Pale blue blood. Maybe Detective Goodman was actually an alien. This proves that something really happened in front of this locker. I make a note of it on the floor plans. Hey, if you didn't want my opinion, you shouldn't have asked. Hey, Pale, look at the time. Was there something you needed to be going to? It's just that Mr. Edgeworth's inquiry committee should be letting out soon. Oh no, dich kenne ich doch auch. Going to give them my report for the day. It might help, you know. Report? You mean your note written on the back of that flyer? The one that says nothing but no problems? Hey, it's Mr. Ashworth we're talking about. I'm sure he can use a report like this. I believe in him. Who needs enemies when you've got friends like Detective Gumshoe? I'm off, pal. Later. I should probably see what Edgeworth has to say to you. So. Ich sag dir nichts dazu. Aber können wir das jetzt zeigen? Kriegen wir auch seine ID? Officer Meekins, could you take a look at this? Sorry, sir. Really sorry, but I have no idea what this is. Warte, er hat hier keine ID drauf? What? Vielleicht kommt es später erst. Leider nichts Neues. Naja, Zeit für Edgeworth. Die kleinen Steel Samurai Fanboy. Oh no. Weg mit dir. Ah, guest. My apologies. Oh, it's you. Have we met somewhere? Huh? Mr. Edgeworth, I beg your leave. So long. Is Edgeworth here? There, standing by the window, a teacup in his hand. Right. He has the hotel bring him tea service? Mr. Edgeworth, you're back from the District Prosecutor's Office inquiry? I am. By the way, Detective Gumshoe was looking for you. Ah yes, he brought me the latest information, it seems. Really? Was it helpful? Apparently a new French restaurant is opening here, near here. Ich frage mich, ob sie das später reingepatcht haben oder schon daran gedacht haben. Je nachdem, wann das DLC rauskam. Oh, scheiße, die Welpen sterben wieder. I think he was trying to console me somehow. The real info is on the other side, Edgeworth. Poor Mr. Edgeworth. I think this whole thing is really taking a toll on him. Komm, jetzt sag du uns wenigstens was zu diesem SL9-Fall. Well, such a prestigious award. Why would we just leave it on the couch? Yeah, you think he wanted to show this thing off more than that giant steel samurai? Then again, Edgeworth has always been like that. Really? Hey, I should write this down. Tell me what he was like a kid. As a kid. Back in elementary school, he won awards for all kinds of things. speech contests, essays, playing the flute, golf tournaments. That doesn't exactly sound like typical elementary school stuff. But he always hated receiving awards. He'd make some smart remark like... I've known the path I've walked. No one else needs to tell me. God damn it. Seine Hand riesig. Ich glaube, er kriegt seine ganze Faust in den Mund. That's how he always been. Kind of gets under your skin, doesn't it? Wow, this jacket is even lazier than his usual ones. This must be his lucky trial jacket. Lucky jacket, right? I've never seen him wear it. I'm sure there's a story behind why it's in a frame. Maybe I'll be naughty and take a picture. Getting way too excited about this. Mr. Edward has such a comfy sofa. Sofa like this make me want to curl up and take a nap. I bet he pours over his case files here until the wee hours of the morning. Then he takes off his jacket, rolls up his sleeves, and goes to sleep using his arms as a pillow. I don't believe it. She's actually daydreaming about Edward working. I bet in the morning he has sofa hair and little creases in his cheek from the seams. He's so cool. Sofa hair is cool. Work desk. It's quite tidy, as one might expect. What a nice desk. Easy to use and easy on the eyes. It's polished so high I can see my own reflection. Strange. Why are you just picture Detective Gumshoe? I held the nameplate as a souvenir. Don't. He'll sue you. My, my, my. What an amazing bouquet. No kidding. Hey, there's a card on it. Back from the dead. Wendy. Wendy. I've heard that name somewhere before. And here beside it, a giant steel samurai. Wow, I want one. Huh. There's something written on the bottom of his foot. But if... Warte, wir heben einfach das Ding an. Ist ja fucking rude. Between a rock and a hard place, Wendy. Wendy, ist sie Mr. Edward's Fiance? Hoffentlich nicht. I don't think so. So, da ist wieder der Chat Tea Leaves Enjoyer versus the average Tea Bag Enjoyer. Oh, cute. What a pretty tea set. I got more for that instant tea bags myself. Amazing! The drawer below is filled with packets of tea leaves. They're all sorted by place of origin and flavor. Look at this royal blend. What an exquisitely splendid concoction. There's such a thing as taking your hobby too far. Hey, a chessboard! I'm not up to my chess, but it looks like blue's in a bit of a tight spot. The red knights have surrounded the blue pawn. Huh? Those horses are mountain knights. The swords have really sharp edges. And she got that poor pawn. His head is kind of spiky. Kind of reminds me of you. Mr. Edgeworth must be an avid chess player. What's wrong, Mr. Edgeworth? Edges surrounding a paw with spiky hair. Nah, it's nothing. So, das hatten wir auch schon alles. So. Wow. What a view. It must be nice to have another song. So, da, wenn man rausspringen würde, wie lange man braucht. Let's talk. Edge boy. So, how did the inquiry committee go? Committee. Actually, they decided to treat this not as a case of concealing evidence. As a communications error during the investigation. Concealing evidence? Yes, apparently there are some who believe they concealed evidence. They gave me a warning. You were lucky this time. Again. Oh, und schon wieder ein Papi tot. again? I've heard him say that so many times. Ever since that case 2 years ago. Are you okay for trial tomorrow? Well, I'm still the presiding prosecutor attorney. However, something happened? They gave control of the investigation over to the police department. The police department? Yes, any further investigation for this case will be directed by the chief of police, Gant. I couldn't do nothing but wait for his results. I see. Why, I ask you, why? All along, I've done only what I believe is right. I have nothing to be ashamed of. But still, well, I've never seen him this out of sorts. Right, please, and prosecute on this case. You don't expect me to sit here and discuss the case with you over a cup of tea? I'll pass on the tea. Just tell me about the case. Mr. Wright, Mr. Edgeworth just told you no in a very polite manner. Whose side are you on, anyway? Maybe if you just show me my best evidence, I can get some reaction out of him. Oh, shit. He must be talking about his father's murder in that elevator. So, nochmal. I know you. You probably got a hold of some information already, right? It all has to do with the case you were on. The SL9 incident. Some dark suspicion you were wrapped up in. You are the man who revived the worst memory of my life. I figured I'd be telling you about this sooner or later. He must be talking about his father's murder in that elevator. Okay, Edgeworth, why don't you tell me about it? Tell me the truth. Natürlich verschiedene Sachen, die das triggern können. Alright, I better check this now. As I was saying, I... Huh? What's this? A record of ID card usage? Edgeworth, you went into the evidence room that day, didn't you? Just before the incident occurred, no less. Yes, that's true. Why, Mr. Edgeworth? Please don't look at me like that. I was asked to go. By Chief Gant, no less. The Chief of Police? He wanted evidence for a case that wrapped up half a year ago. But he told me he wanted me to keep it here in the prosecutor's office. It was solved, right? It would have to be if the evidence was already filed. The chief is never one to explain himself. In any case, on the day of the stabbings, I brought this back here. Can I ask what kind of case it was? I can't say. It really has nothing to do with the current case. Now I'm curious about this other case. I'd better make a note of it. Screwdriver. Evidence from a past case of Edgeworth's, brought back to his office by Gant's request. Unrelated evidence. Stubborn as always. I told you it has nothing to do with the current case.
SL9 incident was a heinous serial killing case. The head of the investigation was the deputy chief of police at the time, Damon Gant. That the wacky old coot was involved in the case 2 years ago too then. He was a top officer and it was my first time working with him. I was nervous. Oh, you get nervous too, Mr. Edgeworth? What I want to know is why he was the deputy chief of police on the investigation. In truth, I used slightly more extreme methods than normal. We're dealing with a vicious murderer. If I let him go, the blood would be on my hands. We won our guilty verdict and the killer was executed. Wait, you didn't? Of course not. I didn't touch the evidence. Yes, I would do anything in my power to win a trial. However, I do have a code and I follow it faithfully. By the way, Emma, the chief prosecutor wanted to know something. My sister? What? If you're still studying forensic science. Huh? Yes, of course. Why, just today, Mr. Wright and I were using this. Luminal testing fluid, huh? Well done. Oh nein, noch mehr Minigames. You might have use for this. Aluminum powder for taking fingerprints. It's been chemically treated for better adhesion. For me? Are you sure? We are the enemy, you know. No say in today's investigation. Do as you will. Edgeworth, I'm really... No need to thank me. Here, take your powder and these fingerprint files for everyone involved. Thanks. How about giving these to Detective Gumshoe as well? Covers fingerprints and handprints for comparison with fingerprint files. Well, let's get going. One last investigation. Right. I do remember seeing a suspicious handprint somewhere. Kannst du den auch hier benutzen? Ah, ich darf es nicht benutzen. Schade. Also doch kein Minigame. Alle weg. Our investigation turned up a suspicious handprint. Here, in this blood on the detective's evidence locker. Let's use the secret weapon we just borrowed. Right, let's get started. First, choose a finger. A finger? Each finger leaves behind a slightly different imprint. So let's choose the finger that will have left behind the clearest print. Really can tell the difference at a glance. Quite procrastinating, and choose a finger. Also entweder Daumen oder der hier. Okay, now it's time to check for prints. Let me show you how it's done. I'm starting to get that sparkle in her eyes. First, we sprinkle the aluminum powder around. Huh? How do you do that? With enter, see? Ah, it looked like that did the trick. The aluminum powder adheres completely to the print. Once the powder is well spread, blauer Ray. Ach, stimmt. Auf dem DS musstest du es wirklich selber noch wegblasen. Huh? How do you do that? Einmal schön ins Mikro blasen. With E. Exciting, I know. Imagine you blowing out the candles on the birthday cake. Tja, das haben sie wohl nicht rausgenommen. See? Wow.
That looks like fun. It might take some getting used to, though. It's fine. It won't go up your nose or anything. Just pour the powder on thick and blow away the extra. Those are the basics of fingerprinting, Mr. Wright. I guess I better give it a try. Mann mit dem Koks ist da, Mama. Aha, you did it. You found one. But this looks nothing like a fingerprint. Hmm. How did you mention it? I guess it doesn't. What does it mean? I think it means we're out of luck. Out of luck? The person who left this handprint must have worn gloves. Don't tell me we've been wasting our time here. Hey, calm down. It's just the way it goes sometimes with scientific investigations. Also konnte man hier keine richtig oder falsch auswählen. But it does seem a shame. While we're at it, why don't we look for other prints? Other prints? Look at the locker door again closely. It seems like there are fingerprints outside the bloody handprint as well. Let's see if we can find a clear print. Fingerprints outside the blood. Ta-da! Yay! Print so clear, it's dazzling. Dazzling? Anyway, this print took a lot of effort to find. Let's match it up right away. So we're not done yet? This is quite a process. Well, there's no point in finding a fingerprint. And not knowing who the owner is, right? Guess she's right. Look at the fingerprints data we got from Mr. Edgeworth. And point out to the person who Fink left these prints. Huh? I am supposed to know who it was? I could make a pretty good guess. The bloody handprint and the fingerprints are in different places, right? It means that the prints probably don't have anything to do with our case. So whose fingerprints would we most likely find in this evidence locker? 64? 22, 33, 36, 30. Was für eine Überraschung. Aha. These prints belong to a detective. Warum guckt er so böse? Something wrong, Mr. Wright? He gave me this so what look. I guess that's probably because I was thinking, so what? Okay, so we came up with nothing this time, but there's always next time. Sometimes you hit, sometimes you miss. You gotta roll with the punches, Mr. Wright. Thanks for the sympathy. Wait, if I remember correctly. There was one other handprint in this room. Let's check it out. This is where we got a luminal fluid reaction, right? Right, there was a handprint here. Okay, want to try using this? Okay, let's check it for prints. That's the spirit. But I have to warn you about something first. What? The area of the blood was wiped away, right? The owner ended up using chemical means. Any prints in that area will have been wiped away too. Oh, right. So that means no prints? Would you say the probability of your hypothesis is high? Don't ask me. Anyway, must try to find prints that weren't wiped away. Prints other than the ones left by the bloody hand. Enter dust. Huh? Oops. Muss ich jetzt auf das... Oder kann ich da checken? Okay, jetzt bin ich wieder ein bisschen verwirrt. Nee. So, sollte Jake Marshall sein. Hey, these fingerprints, they... Whose are they? Whose? Is it somewhere I know? It's Officer Marshall. Huh? Officer Marshall? Jake Marshall? One on a bloody handprint left in the evidence room. Print had been wiped. That's got to be a coincidence. He's not involved in the crime. Emma, this is decidedly different from Detective Gumshoe's prints. The luminal reaction, the blood and the fingerprints are in the same place. Oh. Oh. With Jack Marshall's fingerprints on a white blood stain. But why would Officer Marshall? It looks like our investigation is finally turning up some results. Guess this is what you'd call decisive evidence. I don't believe it. So, diesmal werde ich aber nicht Roundabout spielen, sonst wird ja alles gesperrt. Okay. Dann hören wir mal für heute hier auf. So, ja, Day 3 Trial. So. So, es gibt also wieder immer wieder jemand anders, der der Phoenix Wright weiter streamt. Und er ist erst bei Fall 2? Ich glaube, das ist Fall 2, ja. Können wir ja mal versuchen, da so rüber zu raiden. Dann euch noch einen schönen Abend. Oder mal gucken wir mal, was mit League ist.
Erstmal eine kurze Pause vom Stream.
Bis zum nächsten Mal. Bye bye.